Alrighty, welcome to another Kaldheim Draft here at channel4world.com. Oh, welcome back, Midgard Serpent. Thank you for 62 months. What do we got here? Well, we got some cards. We got Cosmos Elixir, so at the end of your turn, you gain two, unless you're at 21 or more life, in which case you draw a card. It's also Poison the Cup, which is a decent removal spell, and Cyril's Pac-Man, Behold the Multiverse. All the good cards. I find Elixir to be pretty strong. It punishes control decks really badly, and the gaining two is still pretty good against aggro, so I'm happy enough first picking Cosmos Elixir and following it up with, oh, there's Clarion Spirit and Cyril's Pac-Mate. Clarion Spirit is a really, really good card. I'm going to take that Clarion Spirit. I found this card to be extremely hard to beat, and you know, maybe we won't draft a snow deck. We'll see. We'll see. We'll keep ourselves open. Oof, there's a snow-covered mountain, though. No, I think looking at this pack, there's Sculptor of Winter, Snow-Covered Mountain. There's Raven Wings. I think that the pack mate does go better with Cosmos Elixir. That is true. But I would rather just take the best cards here. And I actually might just take Raven Wings here, because Cosmos Elixir is actually fine in aggressive decks too. Hi, dog. Hi, Jules. Jules is chilling down here. I mean, this pack is pretty weak, so I don't feel too bad just taking a kind of a colorless card. Oh, they're making it tough because there's a Shimmering Drift Veil here. And I do really like that. There's also a Woodland Chasm, but there's also a Battlefield Raptor and a Gold Vein pick. All right, you know what? We're gonna go a different direction here. We're going to take the Battlefield Raptor. We're going to draft an aggressive white deck here. Veil is certainly the safe pick. I would rather pick up Battlefield Raptor over pick up, because first of all, it's a one mana spell instead of a two mana spell for this. Also, I just took an equipment. Also, this wields equipment pretty nicely. We'll see how this turns out here. I mean, we were 14-0, so we got to give some back now, right? Yeah, the runes in general haven't been great. I wouldn't mind wheeling the rune. I mean, if I wanted to draft snow, I would have taken Cyril's Packmate followed by two snowlands probably. Oh, nice. Kaya's Onslaught. And a Stalwart Valkyrie and a Gold Vein pick. So there's a lot of good white aggro cards here. I think I'm just going to take the Kaya's Onslaught. I think this card is quite strong. Just take Berserk here. Teamer Battle Rage. Get to equip a Raven Wings onto something and then... Look, now there's a Bound in Gold and a Galtal Guardian and a Goldmaw Champion. So white is definitely open. So is snow, though. Look at this late snow land here. I'm sorry I didn't win a game, Matt Combs. It's not always easy. All right, I'll take the Bound in Gold. I've been impressed with Bound in Gold. It does the thing. Hey, Jules. Come here. Come here, dog. Bad dog. Ooh, nice Doomscar Oracle. This works nicely with all the stuff we got going on here. Still more snow lands, but not worried about it. Yeah, I think snow would have been a good place to be, but I actually really like our start too. Run Amok would be very good for this deck as well. Ooh, so now there's Divine Gambit, which I actually have found to be quite good in this kind of deck. Hey, what's up, Fader? Welcome back to the 4-month resub. Hope you're doing well. Oh man, your wife's car got stolen. Sorry about that, Crixo Mix. I'm probably going to take Codespell Cleric here, just because it's so good with like Battlefield Raptor, Clarion Spirit, and I already just picked up a Bound in Gold, and I have a Kaya's Onslaught, so let's just do this. I mean, if we can be mono white, I'm fine with that too. I'm good. I'm good there. What are the best archetypes in this format? Snow, aggro. So if I want to take a red card, I could take Craven Hulk. I'm kind of thinking Wings of the Cosmos. It's a good cheap card. Could help line up some good Kai's Onslaught stuff, though. I guess it doesn't do that much extra damage. I think Raider's Carve is not great. I like one mana tricks. Just ways to save your creature for one mana is pretty nice. Plus, it also gives flying and untap, so you can use it as like an Alpha Strike thing where you just like cast it on your Doomscar Oracle to hit them for four. Oh, nice. I like Rune of Sustenance quite a bit, but I think Goldmaw Champion is going to be better here, is my guess. Goldmaw Champion is really nice with with extra ways to pump it, and it's good for aggro. I like that. Oh, the gold vein pick wield. Perfect, perfect. Is the code spell cleric deck real? Yeah, yeah, you definitely can. I mean, we're drafting it now. You'll get to see, I guess. Rune plus wings is very good. Mm-hmm. I'm going to take Tormentor's Helm here. I think the armory is pretty bad. And Cavalry is not bad, but I'd rather have the Helm here. No, Cavalry's good. My creatures are kind of small here, so I didn't wheel any of the white cards I wanted, but I guess I might play Valor. I'm not going to play a Snowland here, and I don't think Seize the Spoils is where I want to be. I've used some of the stuff from the Magic source books to play D&D, yeah. I haven't like run a campaign based in the Magic world, though. I find the land to be... tap lands are more punishing in decks like these, and it's pretty slow. I also don't really want too many double red cards. Like, this is a very good Clarion Spirit Star, yeah. Is Cosmos Elixir better in control? Oh, all right. Well, I'll probably play that God's Hall Guardian. There we go. I mean, this is a sign. Look at this. Look at this. The last pick run amok. It's like getting a Doomblade last pick, right? I'm into that. I guess I'll take Doomscar Oracle here. This card is good. It's a good aggro card and a good control card. Also, pretty nice with the Cosmos Elixir. I mean, there's nothing else here. I mean, I'll play Axe Guard Armory if there's nothing else in the pack I want to take. So I'll probably wheel that one too. There's a white rare. It's true. There's a white rare. Probably just going to take the Stalwart Valkyrie here. This card, I think, is pretty bad. Yeah. There's also Dwarven Reinforcements, but even though I got a last pick run amok, I'd rather just take more white cards. All right, I'm going to take the one drop. That's what I'm in for. There's Bounding Gold, and I might wield a Gold Maw Champion, but one drop beater. We are getting in there. Greetings from Reno. Hey, what's up, MTG Glarewolf? Played a lot of tournaments in Reno. Oh, look at all these white cards. Oh, yeah. I don't have any runes. I might just take a second Kaya's Onslaught here and then try to wheel Codespell. Well, any of these cheap creatures is fine with me. Yeah, that works for me. The two Kaya's Onslaught means I probably do want to try to get Run Amok in, especially... Well, the thing is, it's really nice to be mono. Like, getting to play 15 or 16 lands and have them just all be planes is pretty good. This Cosmos Elixir is probably not in there. I would rather not split. Well, I'm not really getting high on tricks though, Nicole, because I'm not sitting here saying I'm gonna play Valor of the Worthy and Wings and the Helm and Run Amok and two more equipment and two Kai's Onslaught. I'm just taking these and I'll choose which are the best ones. I agree that if I played all these cards, it would be too much. Iron Man, they are from a sealed box. Yes, they are. We guarantee they're unsearched. The packs, we opened the box on stream, labeled every pack, and that, you know, we got it sealed. So. Yeah, I don't think splashing Run Amok is out of the question for sure. But, oh, yeah, sorry. I always forget that I should move this. There we go. You can see the whole thing. Do I think combat tricks are better in this format than others? Well, it's not just blanket, are they better, but like Run Amok and Kaya's Onslaught are pretty high rate combat tricks, and this format lends itself to them reasonably well. There's good support for them. I don't want Divine Gambit. I don't really want another Raven Wings here. I think I would take Run Amok here, even though there's a good chance I'll wheel it. Yes, what Sponzi said is also true. Boast works very nicely with them. I just want more cheap creatures, which is why I snapped off like Usher of the Fallen. I'm hoping to pick up some more cheap ones. So now, do I want a Shieldmate, Story Seeker? I just don't think I want a Rune here. Rune is really nice with these things, but I feel like this deck's going to be trying to kill them pretty nicely. So for the box breaks, you don't choose what color you buy into. It's random. It's randomed. I think that the Shieldmate's going to be... I don't care about Lifelink that much, so I think I'd rather have a backup creature. I'm not going to play Giant Ox. I'm not going to play Raider. There's a chance I play Tormentor's Helms. Like the second one here for sure. The Ox breaks. Okay, Codespell Cleric. Yeah, I'm gonna take that over to Third Helm for sure. And the Armory Wield. Yeah, I mean, I'll take it here. I'm not gonna play Valor, and I don't care about Snowlands. I'll probably play it now that I'm playing more red here. Yep, sure can. Why did I pass Rally? I'm not gonna put Rally in this deck, I don't think. Here, let me see if I can add a thing. I think there's a chance I play Dwarven Reinforcements. I don't think I'm gonna play Forging the Tyrite Sword. All right. Why not Raider? I don't know. Immersion Raider? I would prefer my red cards not be. Look at how open white is. It's actually a real question here which one I want. I think I actually would rather just have Goldmaw Champion. I'd just rather have more creatures. All right, I'm going to take the Codespell Cleric. Now I'll take Divine Gambit. I like Divine Gambit as more than Raven form because it's not a 2-for-1. White is like incredibly open here. I actually think I'll take the rune here. Yeah, we have another pack somehow. Like at this point, I'm actually thinking I don't need even to play red necessarily. Clarion Spirit, that might be the literal best card I could open. I don't know if there's a white rare better than Clarion Spirit. And then I'll undoubtedly wield this Goldmaw Champion or pick if I want it, whatever. Yeah, so I think we are pretty clearly the only white drafter. Now, yeah, maybe Halvar or something would be better. So now the question is, oh yeah, Starnheim Unleashed. Okay, there are some rares that are better than the Clarion Spirit, but it's pretty close. Which of these cards do I want? Bloodline Pretender is not bad. It doesn't work. Oh no, it does work with the spirits. Actually, it's entered the battlefield. The sword is a little expensive. I don't think I'm getting there on the sword. I'm probably not going to play Cosmos Elixir at this point either. I think I'll take Bloodline Protector and then just pick between all those white cards when they come back. Is my guess. Runeforge Champion. Ooh, I picked up a rune. And I'll probably pick up the other rune. Yeah, Runeforge Champion is pretty nice in that case. It's also Cole the Forge Master. I don't think that one is particularly great. Runeforge Champion is nice as a double spell turn here. Yeah, I'll try to find a second rune here, but this deck looks pretty good to me. At this point, I'm probably not going to want the pick, but I don't know, maybe. +1/+1 equipment's not bad. I mean, this is already 23 here. I would like another couple cheap cards, another cheap creature. Oh, Valor of the Worthy, I don't really want that one in. All right, and now I'll just take the Shield Mate again. Kind of the same pick. I could use the Warhorn Blast. The Foretell +2/+1 to all your stuff. That would be nice. Oh, Speak of the Cheon. Yeah, there's that. There's also Rune of Speed. Huh. That's actually close, because the fact that I picked up the champion means that I could use Rune of Speed, and Rune of Speed on like one of these is pretty nice. I also am going to wield a blast, I think. Well, this pack's pretty weak. 1, 2. Yeah, I don't know how likely it is that I'm going to wield the blast. I'm just going to take the blast. And then now I think I'll just take another. Yeah, I'll take another Valkyrie here. I'll take a Story Seeker. I mean, I'd rather play mono white because look at this deck. I can just play 15 land mono white and then not have to worry about color screw and then end up in a spot where I just have all gas and I just have all plains, so I don't need to play mountains or anything. Yeah, Cheon works for WotC, making our game better. You know, the game we all love. Unfortunately, it does mean it's harder for him to stream and whatnot. He sticks Story instead of Glory. The only thing that I miss out on, yeah, I'll take another Gold Maw, is Run Amok plus Kaya's Onslaught is a pretty nice combo. Now I wish I had not all the Gold Maws, though. All the Gold Maws do make me want Gold Vein Pick a little bit better. But do I want a second Raven Wings? I guess so. If I get pick up two runes, I don't think I want the fourth Gold Maw champion because they don't stack super well. Yeah, I guess all the Codespell clerics make the second pick better. All right, yeah. I will play two runes easily. Oh, and I'll play all the Codespell clerics I can get. This deck is nice. The Challenger Shirt's somewhere in my house here. At this point, I don't even think I play Galzhal Guardian. I guess I could take Alpine Meadow. I'm not going to play. Sure, whatever. I mean, I don't even have any expensive cards. Like, Stalwart Valkyrie costs 2 mana a lot of the time. I wish I picked up more Battlefield Raptors. There just weren't any. Yeah, I'm really giving you the royal sampler of Kaldheim drafts here. So, I want 15 land. Definitely want the Warhorn Blast. All my cards cost 2 mana. I can play every card in my deck on 2 lands except for Warhorn Blast and Bloodline Pretender, I suppose. Oh, and the Gold Maw. I could probably cut... Maybe at this... Do I want to cut Raven Wings now? Raven Wings seems like a really good way to push through here. I think I cut a Gold Maw Champion. I'm not cutting any of the ones. I could cut a Story Seeker. It's nice with the pick. Is it crazy to cut Kaya's Onslaught? The Onslaught... The Pretender is like a little weak. I guess it's only good with Clarion Spirit, so... I could cut a pick. I could. The problem is the picks and the Gold Maws do kind of combine nicely with each other. I don't know. I could probably cut one. And then... Boom, boom, boom. What are the other creature types? Yeah, I mean, I've got 7 clerics and then 3 spirits and 8 warriors, but the spirit, obviously, I can make multiples of, so. I got one more cut. I think I'm going to cut the Story Seeker with the double rune. And... I think this is good. I think with the 2 equipment and the 2 Gold Maws, 15 lands is fine. Yeah, all right. This deck's wild. Chat, CFP is doing another cool thing on Saturday. It's on Saturday, right? Yeah, the Kaldheim release party. It's basically like a pre-release. Yeah, it's this weekend. You can check it out there. Yeah, this looks fine to me. It's pretty cool. You don't actually... You can join with any Kaldheim product you want. You can go ahead and play. The Lords of Limited, Ethan and Ben, are doing a Deck Doctor thing from 10 to noon Pacific. And they'll help you build your decks. And it's gonna be sweet. You have a lot of opportunities to both play Kaldheim. It's via the Discord. You can also show off your pulls. You can do a lot of cool stuff like that. Yeah, let's go rune on the pick here. Oh, didn't get not punished for putting the land back, and then I'll just hit with this and they can trade with the Frenzied Raider, but then I can play the Valkyrie off of that. Mm-hmm. Works for me. Also, a lifelinking pick is going to give me a lot of gas over the course of the game. And so now let's go Stalwart Valkyrie exiling the Codespell Cleric. And boom. If they have a removal spell, which they probably do, they'll kill that, but that's okay. I drew like a lot of my buffers and not a lot of my cheap creatures, but I still think this hand is going to be fine. This is just going to buy me a lot of time. And one of the advantages of playing 15 land, I draw less land than my opponent. All right, land, Goldmaw Champion, equip. And then next turn, they don't know, but I'm going to get to go wings and equip. Yep, I'll be able to rune up the wings at some point too. Hopefully I don't have a removal spell here. Dwarven Reinforcements, all right. Let's go for it here. And then hit in the air for 4 lifelink, and I get a treasure, so if I draw a creature, I'm going to Rune of Sustenance. The wings. Oh, I see. Okay. I was like, how? It's going to be hard to play to choose it there, but there we go. I've drawn half the land in my deck. All right. Doomscar Titan. Oy. So I'm taking a lot of damage here. I'm so close to killing them. Let's see. So if I Kaya's Onslaught, so I guess what I can do is, this doesn't have vigilance. I'm just going to suspend this, and then I guess I can suspend this too and then pass. So let's see. If I block the Titan, give this +1/+1 and lifelink, I go to 7. Oh, I'm just dead. I'm aware it has menace, but they're probably going to attack with multiple things if they could. Because if they didn't, if they just attacked with everything, then I would actually not die there. But I'm aware that I was dead. So. All right. Well, there goes our win streak, very quickly. That's okay. Mm-hmm. We lost a game, I know. Brutal. 21-0 Dream is dead. It's okay. See, look, this hand is great. I don't think I play the Codespell Cleric here. Yona no longer guards this place. We do, okay. Yeah, interesting. Finn the Fang Bearer. Let's foretell the cleric, and then next turn I'm gonna go Oracle plus Codespell Cleric. I didn't play Elixir because I didn't want a 4 mana card in my deck. I did not expect that to be the play after that. Okay. Let's play Doomscar Oracle into Cleric here. I'm actually just going to put it on there because this already trades for the Finn here. No, the double rune doesn't double your life gain. Life link doesn't stack. We're playing 15 lands here. And if we trade here, they've got a deck here. In the blue rune. All right. 5 color runes. I like it. This is sweet. So they're going to equip the thing probably into make it a 2/4 flyer. And so next turn they get to go get an equipment. They probably have a second one, but I like their brew here. Yeah, we're getting infected despite having a bunch of life gain cards in our deck. I mean, they should probably just attack. They're on a pretty quick clock here. Need to draw. I guess I need to draw a bounding gold here on Blizzard Brawl. Okay. That's less bad because now if I draw a land, I can play Valkyrie plus Codespell Cleric. All right, I guess I'll play Valkyrie anyway. Hit for two. Yeah, this so far hasn't worked out so well. Let's see. What do I need to draw next turn? I mean, the thing that's kind of annoying is even drawing a land doesn't get me there. Or sorry, if I don't draw a land, I need to double spell for the cleric. So I guess if I don't draw a land, I can play Rune of Sustenance here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, our deck's mono, a little 15 land mono white deck here. Mm-hmm. All right. So now we have that. So now, I guess, I think I'm more likely to want the rune there. Okay, now I can play the cleric. Now I'm going to put the counter on the Valkyrie. Then I'll attack with the Codespell Cleric because it's going to trade for this either one way or another. I might still die to Infect. In fact, very likely still. Like, if they kill my Stour Valkyrie, I don't really have a good answer. So I guess I got to hope they don't. They do have a Runed Crown as well with a Rune of Flight. So even if this trades off, basically I need to... Oh, yikes. I need to draw Bounding Gold here or Clarion Spirit. I mean, the two Clarion Spirits I have are the best card in the deck. So, but I have not done... I guess this turn I actually couldn't have even Clarion Spirited here. Yes, they are splashing the Saga with just the one equipment because they got to get their things. Oh, Raven Wings would be nice, yeah. Okay. You know, should we not be playing this Warhorn Blast? Feels like it's good with Kaya's Onslaught. Yeah, no, it's fine in here. Need to not draw it every game on my opening hand, but who knows. I think Mono White was, I think, very clearly open. We were the only white drafter. But those two games didn't work out. Yeah, main deck Wings is fine. Is my deck bad? No, it is the opponents who are wrong. Ooh, this is a nice hand. See, like, this is a good hand. You get to play Raptor, I think. It's actually interesting. I think I am going to play the Battlefield Raptor on turn one. Because, look, if I draw a land, I can suspend Oracle turn two and go Spirit into Oracle turn three. If I don't draw a land, I could just play a Gold Vein pick, maybe. Didn't draw a land, but I drew that. All right, yeah, let's just play Gold Vein pick here. And then this gives me the ability to kind of get around not drawing lands. Though if they leave mana up, it's a little rough. Okay. Oh, wow. So yeah, this is gonna be great. Because now I can Gold Vein pick. And then play Clarion Spirit. Then play Codespell Cleric, triggering the Clarion Spirit. And I'm going to put the counter on the Spirit. See, this is what we were talking about. And now here we are. Like, this, like, that turn was absurd. I put 5 power with a creature on the play, and I got to equip a Gold Vein pick here. Sure. Really? All right. Well, I don't know if that's going to work out for them. Do I want to play around a sweeper, like a Crippling Fear? But if they had Crippling Fear, they just snap it off there, right? Like, pretty hard to imagine they don't do that. Okay, let's make my things. Whatever. This isn't a coward stream. Boom, boom, boom. No reason not to. I mean, if they have Crush the Weak or Crippling Fear, then I'll end up with a 1-1 Human Warrior, a Goldmane pick, and then a Doomscar Oracle plus that. Blood on the Snow is not a card they can cast before they die here. Oh, there's my Warhorn Blast. They're at 10. I assume I just attack with everything. Right now, if they just block my two Clarion Spirits, they're taking 2, 4, 7, 9. Block like that. Okay. That's 10, so presumably they have something. Make a treasure. Or not. All right. I guess I'll take it. Well, Clarion Spirit did its thing. Onslaught would win if I had to cast it, but I did not. All right. Let's get going here. All right, we got on the board. We're not playing Cosmo Elixir because this deck is playing 15 land and just wants all lower curve cards. I'm not 100% sure about this Warhorn Blast. It's good in games when your deck's doing the thing. All right, I'm in for this. But maybe it's bad enough in games that... Or you're not, I don't know. I don't think I play the Codespell Cleric on a 1 here. I think I just play turn 1, land go, turn 2, Shieldmate. And then turn 3, hopefully just play a Runeforge Champion. But if not, we'll see. Yeah, I'm kind of thinking that too, Nicole, that I think I might cut Warhorn Blast just for another creature here. Because I've got two runes, like two equipments. Like, I don't know, feels like I could do a little better. Oops. Land go. I don't think I want to play a 16th land, no. Land, play Shieldmate. You know, and then now next turn I can go Runeforge Champion and then get my second Rune of Sustenance and then Codespell Cleric into another spell or something like that. They're just chilling over there, huh? Axeguard Cavalry. All right. Let's just send. I don't think they're going to block, but no reason to give them info. Search my library for a rune. Pass the turn here. Bump, bump, bump. Will they have like a random 3-2 or something? Or are they foretelling a Doom Bolt? Or Demon Bolt? Okay, well, I'm not going to play a rune into that, so... let's see... I don't think I need to play things before combat. I think I'm just going to pass an attack because... Oh, thanks for the raid, Goldfish. I don't know if that's Seth or who's heading over, but I appreciate it. We drafted a nice little mono white deck. Play Clarion Spirit. Yeah. And then play a Codespell Cleric. And at some point, if they want to use their Demon Bolt on my Clarion Spirit, they can. Boom, boom, boom. Put a counter on that. And then pass. No reason to walk into the card. I'm pretty sure they have, yeah. All right, kill my Runeforge Champion. That works for me. Raider discarding a card or Doomscourge. Interesting. Okay, so I have the Runeforge in the graveyard, so let's just play Valk. Bum, 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 bum. And do I want to play the Raptor? Yeah, let's just get... No, let's draw my card. Let's just put this on the flyer here. Make him another flyer. Draw, and if I draw a land, I could even play the Battlefield Raptor. Though I'm not even sure that I want to, because that I want my Clarion Spirit to go off next turn. Because I'm not attacking for that much. I think I'd rather just guarantee the double spell here. Top blue common. Oh, Behold the Multiverse by quite a bit. Plus, this plays around a sweeper, which they easily could have. It's becoming less likely they have a sweeper. Oh wow, holding that plans is really good. You should hold your lands if you don't need them in this format. There's a lot of discards. There's just two commons that discard here. Bound in gold. Could use bound in gold. So they're 12. Right now they're taking 6 in the air. How likely is it that they have... Kind of feel like I should just crash in the air for 6 here and then just pass to play around a sweeper. I did a limited set review, in fact. CFP does have a Discord, yes. Macho Macho Man, welcome. 5 month resub. What is up? They're 8. If they block those two, they take 7. I think if I bound in gold attacked here. Let's just chill. I mean, I'm gonna hit him for 6, but oh yeah, Uber Cactuar. That deck is great. Just gonna chill with all my spells in hand in case they do have a sweeper. Could refresh here. Avocado Hydra, welcome to the divination. Avocado Hydra is nice. Yes, in general you should spread around your stuff. Like putting a counter on the Clarion Spirit is not really where you want to be. Crippling Fear. The two black -3/-3 to everything here. I have not seen WandaVision, no. I am probably going to at some point here. What do I want? I'm going to take out Warhorn Blast. Mm-hmm. Yes, I could have put another counter on my 3/2, but then Crippling Fear would have been bad for me. I think I just want another Story Seeker, actually. I kind of want another Gold Vein pick. The picks seem like they'd be very good, especially with the runes. And I think I actually take out Akaya's Onslaught as little as I want to. In fact, maybe the Onslaught, without the Warhorn Blast, the Onslaughts are really not even that impressive. At that point, maybe I do want the Cosmos Elixir once I have double Gold Vein pick. Yeah, I kind of like that, because then I'm more on the rune plus pick, get life gain, generate some treasure, play Elixir, that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. Yes, I was less worried about Crush the Weak than I was Crippling Fear. I just felt like, I mean, they're not in a spot where I could really lose very easily to them playing any one for ones or whatever. All right, let's play Shield Mate here, and then I can go Runeforge Champion, then Spirit plus Rune. There we go. Hey, what's up, Matt? How was Vintage this weekend? I ended up not having time to play, unfortunately. Ooh, Ravenwing's actually a really good draw here to go with these runes. Mistwalker. Swing and a mist. All right, Clarion Spirit into Raven Wings. And just pass. I mean, I could have attacked with a Runeforge Champion, but they're just going to block. Whatever. Let's just chill. So would they play Bears of Lit-Yara? Oh, they're both going to be 4/4s. That's tough. They're both going to beat up on my Clarion Spirit? I don't like it. Let's go Rune of Sustenance, cast with Runeforge Champion on Raven Wings here. No. And I think I play Codespell Cleric. On the Shield Mate. Yeah. Good stuff, Lidless. I'm glad it worked out. Alright, let's play that. Let's just swing in the air. This is gonna be hard. Bears is really good. I think that card is very strong. Pass. I'm waiting on the rune because I want a double spell here next turn. I would like to this is a game where the Warhorn Blast would have been good, but so I think will be if I draw the pick or the other thing, the Cosmos Elixir. No bears. No bears indeed. All right, ordered Gomida. Now they have permanently 4/4s, but I've got a Baneslayer Wings here, +1/+0 lifelink flying. I can grind him out here. The next turn, all of their creatures that have power 4 or greater will deal damage to a creature they don't control. So I assume they're going to beat up my Clarion Spirit, of course. Unless they have a fight card now, which is kind of what it's looking like. The snow fight card, Blizzard Brawl. Based on how they're doing their things. Sure. They're not killing the Clarion Spirit? Weird. Unless they have another way to kill it. But if they kill the Clarion Spirit this turn, then this third saga is really not going to be that good. Okay. Ooh, interesting. Do I get any value of playing these things before combat? I don't really think I do. I think I'm just going to hit with the Shield Mate and see what they do. I don't know why they're killing Runeforge Champion. Maybe because it's a mana, it saves me mana, so it's like frightening or dangerous or something. Who knows? Let's go Rune of Sustenance. I actually do think I want to put it on the Usher. No. Yeah, that seems fine. They are scared of off-color runes. Yeah, I suppose that could be the thing. Make another spirit. Doot. Saw it coming. Okay. Sure. Wow. I cannot play around Crippling Fear at this point, though. Unfortunately, taking out Warhorn Blast didn't work out. They're not killing my Clarion Spirit. Okay. Interesting. I mean, I guess that was the only thing that can attack here. Hey, later, Danilo. Have a good one. Here's where I could use the, like, pick or the Gold Vein Champion or what have you. Ugh, not the Story Seeker. They're at 10. I'll put wings on this thing, and I'm gonna send with these. Basically, I'm willing to throw away a 2-1 here for 3 points of damage. That works for me, and then I'll put wings on the Usher. Pass the turn. They didn't play anything with 5 mana and 3 colors. Now they're going to play a Ravenous Lindworm, unfortunately. I mean, what? Still have nothing? Oh, that one's nice. Oh, I guess I kind of got punished for... yeah. Yeah, I guess they could have run ashore, sure. I kind of got punished for moving it to the thing that actually wasn't going to be attacking this turn. That's fine. I actually don't really want to run into Run Ashore anyway, where they just bounce their Raven Wings and really own me here. No Run Ashore either? I mean, if they're setting me up for the perfect Crippling Fear, then sure. Well, Glimpse is really good. I mean, Gold Maw Champion's going to be very strong here. I'm gonna give this flying, binding the old gods now. My Gold Maw Champion. Oh, they killed my Raven Wings? Is that gonna work out for them? 4, 6, I think that just puts them dead. So I guess the answer is no. All right. I'll take it. I will take it. We're grinding our way back up. We're on Platinum Tier 4. We're getting there. So now we... Yeah, I think I like... It's always a battle between, like, getting more expensive cards in, because you look at the games where you draw 5 or 6 lands and you're like, oh, I just wish I just played more Gold Maw Champions. Or the games where you're on 2 or 3 lands and you're just like, I wish I played more 1-drops or wish I played more lands or whatever. Mm-hmm. I'm on the play. Oh, yeah. I like this. I'm not going to play the Cleric turn 1 because it's such a good turn 3 play to go. Turn 2, Story Seeker. Turn 3, Spirit plus Codespell Cleric, and then bam. Oh, and there's the Gold Maw Champion. Yeah, this is working out nicely. I do think we improved our deck after we made those changes. So that part is nice, at least. Let's play a land. Whoop, that's not what I want to play. Let's play Clarion Spirit. Play Codespell Cleric. And actually, I'm going to put a counter on the Story Seeker. I do like making the flyers better, but this means the Story Seeker can get by whatever they play on turn 3, probably. Especially since I get to play Gold Vein Pick here. You did not miss the box break. Nope. Oh, it doesn't get by that. Ha, funny. Let's just play Gold Maw Champion and pass. Because I can tap down the Recluse next turn and hit for a lot. Hey, later, Strato Gordo. Yeah, I was wondering what you were stuck on, because you had a lot of cards in your hand. Ooh, Glittering Frost on that one, huh? Let's go pick me. Equip there. Attack, tap down the Recluse. Bum, bum, bum. Ah, I see. That makes sense. I was wondering what you got going on. What are my favorite decks or moments from playing in tournaments? Pretty broad question. I like when I got to gutshot Frank Lepore for the win. That was pretty cool. Getting to cover a tournament when look, we won. Simeon Spirit Guide. And they went when they played Cavern of Souls and named it Ape for Simeon Spirit Guide was a pretty nice one too. Disdainful Stroke is tough. Tendrils of My Own Creature was a nice one. Yeah, that was good. All right, if we get this next one, we'll continue giving away the box break slots. Bam. Opponent goes first. All right, we're a gold vein pick aggro deck here is where we are. Oh man, that match against Steve Rubin in the last round of Worlds was incredible because I sequenced my lands wrong such that on one turn I couldn't play a Tarmogoyf. I couldn't play two Tarmogoyfs and instead had to play one Tarmogoyf and play Thoughtseize when he had one card in hand, which I would much rather have just played two Tarmogoyfs. But it turns out his last card was, that changes things, drawing the spirit. His last card is Rest in Peace. So instead of having two 0-1 Goyfs and dying to his Reality Smash, I Thoughtseize the Rest in Peace. My Goyf was a 5-6 and he couldn't attack with the Smasher. And I came back to win from there. That was a punt down one. Yeah, the Tendrils match does not exist online, unfortunately. I'm just going to play this because what is Blue-White going to do to it? Like, maybe they Raven form it. If they do, they do. I will accept. In fact, I might be able to, depending on what they do, go pick, equip, attack for three, use the treasure to play Codespell Cleric. There's definitely a lot of PTs where I felt ahead of the curve. Not even just the ones where I personally did well. Oh. You know what? I'm not attacking into a Iron Verdictor or what have you. Let's go Usher. We were definitely far away from the curve with Blue Green Karn. I'll tell you that much. Pick me. To what extent is being ahead of the curve just the benefit of being on a good team? It's not really the way. Now they don't have a foretell card, so I can attack. Obviously, not really how I would characterize it. Like, being on a team makes you ahead of the curve because the people on the team are good. It's not just that you're on a team. The reason the team is good is because you do stuff like that. How much of that could I have come up with on my own or with whoever I was going to test with? I don't know. I've had tournaments where I've had a really good deck where I didn't prepare with too many people, and I've had tournaments where I prepared with a lot of people where I had a really bad deck. All those things can happen, you know. But the whole point of being on teams is to increase your preparation and your chances. Yeah, Declites, the PT Berlin is on YouTube, though. It's a little harder to find. Goldmaw Champion. Okay, that is not going to do it here. What do I want to do? What to do? Let's go Runeforged Champion. Oh, yeah, I played with Koma. It is very good. And then Codespell Cleric as my second spell. Make a Spirit, and then I think I actually make... Yeah, I'm interested to make Usher of the Fallen into a beater here. And then attack with those two. They want to trade, I'm fine with that. I don't really want to make Clarion Spirit into a brawler, because I'm just not going to throw this into combat, you know? Can I give an example of a bad deck? Blue-Green Karn was bad. The Jeskai Mentor deck we played at PT Battle for Zendikar wasn't very good. Oh yeah, Denver was fun. Boom, boom, boom. And then now next turn, I've got a lot of plays here. I mean, one of the PTs where I think we just put in the hours and had a good result was PT Nagoya when we played Tempered Steel. The best deck in the format. Everyone knew about it. A lot of people chose not to play it because they thought it could get hated out. And we just did our due diligence and found it could not get hated out. It just was that good. Okay, so they got to play Valkyrie on a discount by trading there. But I think that's okay, because getting the 2-3 off the board opens the door for a lot of attacks on my side. Also, my own Valkyrie. So what do I want to do here? How do I want a best battle? I think I'm going to play... Do I play Raven Wings? Yeah, I'm going to play Raven Wings. And then I'm going to play the rune for one mana on the Raven Wings. And kind of hope to draw a land here, but if I draw a spell, that's fine too. All right, well, I drew a land. So now I can equip it to the Codespell Cleric and send with those two. And I don't mind at this point if I trade off the Runeforge Champion. Still not willing to give up the Clarion Spirit. It's got more spirits to make here. I mean, if I had to give you like a list of I wrote an article somewhat recently on Channel Fireball, the five best decks I've ever played. Those are the decks that we felt the most ahead of the curve. It was like Elves, Cobblade or Stoneblade, Eldrazi, Iron Verdict. Okay, sure. Those, I'm trying to think of the other decks because those are like the big ones that I remember. I didn't play the Dragons deck, though. It was very good. Omnicord now. I love that deck, but that was not one of the best decks I've ever played. It was good for the thing. Raven Form, I think, is the card you're thinking of. Oh, speaking of which, you turned Raven Wings into Raven Form. That is pretty good in this particular case. Then they're going to foretell a card. Because now, especially if I just draw a land here, I don't really have great attacks. I could trade. So it actually, I think I'm going to do is I'm going to play. Just going to cast Doomscar Oracle. Cast the Valkyrie for 2 mana. And then I'm just going to attack with everything now. And if they block Clarion Spirit, they take 5 and I trade. And if they block a 1-1, I'm throwing away a 1-1 for 7 damage or 6 damage. Yeah, this works for me. Raven Form was good. Our Band Company deck was good, but I didn't feel like we were super ahead of the curve. We just had some like small edges. If they have Doomscar, that's unfortunate. But if they have Doomscar, they would have blocked to save the most damage. At the Theros PT, where Mono Blue was good, we played Mono Red Devotion, and we were very much behind the curve. Our deck was just bad against the best deck. They had Master of Waves. We couldn't beat them. Okay, it's not a Doomscar. Tempered Steel is one of the best decks I ever played. That was number 4. I'm trying to think of what number 5 is. Bound in Gold on my Stalwart Valkyrie. Okay. If I draw a spell here and I get to go double spell and then attack with everything, probably going to be pretty nice. Raptor made Legacy Death Shadow. He's the one who kind of innovated that. That deck was really good. That was like one of the best decks I've ever played. I think I went like 10-2 at the PT or something like that. It was really good. Sadly lost to Supreme Verdict out of Blue White Miracles to knock us out of top 4. See, look, they just downgraded a 2-2 into a 1-1. I guess it stops me from making a spirit as well, but... Oh. They can eat one of my 1-1s. Yeah. And then they take 8 going to 1. And they actually have no outs in the format now because if they wrath, my Beskir Shieldmate makes a token and kills them. Kaka indeed. Hey, what up, Chimfunks? 34-month resub. Yeah, number 5 Chiron, I'll take my ranking. I think the worst deck we've played at a PT, was probably Blue-Green Karn, especially if you compare that I have a whole team to prep with. When I played a Blue-Black Tog, it was pretty bad. That was like PT Valencia 2007, and I didn't test with very many people. So that certainly wasn't the best. All right, 5-2. I'm on the play. Well, I'm not going to mulligan Battle for Raptor into Gold Vein pick. This is basically Smuggler's Copter. Sorry, Tom. It's okay. This deck would run roughshod over you. Actually, I don't know. This deck, I think, is actually good. But this hand needs to draw one of the busted Clarion Spirits. Oh, actually, the Rune of Sustenance is not bad. Getting to get Gold Vein pick plus Rune of Sustenance going is not bad. Ding, ding, ding. Hopefully, they don't have Well, I guess there's not much removal they can do. Fearless Liberator, huh? Hmm, let's go pick, attack in the air, make my treasure, and I think I just bound and gold that. Just so they don't get to make any dwarves. No reason to give them extra cards here. And, okay, that does not scare me at all. Ooh, Goldmaw Champion? So let's just go Champion, Usher, and hit, make another thing. And I don't think I need to move the pick here. I don't think I'm going to be that. Pick is really good. I've got an activated ability plus, well, it itself, you know, costs mana to move around. Ooh, I guess they could nug. Oh, I can't quite nug me for a card yet. Hey, thanks for the gifted sub, Dust Wizard. Little pick and roll. We kind of are doing a pick and roll here. Also, we kept a 4-land, 3-spell hand and have drawn all spells so far. But part of why you play 15 land, not like it means you never draw land, but I, on average, will draw fewer than my opponents. I believe that this card will start being picked earlier. I think that once people know that this card, how good this card is, it won't go, you know, 4 cards off from the pack, which it kind of frequently does. I think it's funny, so the way these things work, equipment's been pretty bad in the last couple sets for a long time, actually, in limited. Like, most of the equipment sucks. So then people just mentally put equipment lower on their pick order, as it were. Oh, no, that's pretty good. Gets to kill my Goldmaw Champion. Yeah. That card owns Bound and Gold pretty badly. Oh, Cosmos Elixir is actually pretty nice. So I think I'm going to do is, yeah, I'm going to Rune of Sustenance on the pick. Yeah, this is actually perfect. And then they're going to block, I assume. And then my pick is going to make another thing and I can play a Cosmos Elixir and I can draw right away. Yeah. Elixir got in the deck once I added the second Gold Vein pick. Now I'm going to have to discard a card to the Vicious Return, but I've got a Plains to discard, so it actually works out pretty nicely. This is good, this is good. Yep, just discard my Plains. Why even attack with the 2-1? I didn't want to drop below 22. I didn't want them to attack me, and I would have probably blocked if they attacked, so I'd rather just attack then. I mean, maybe I wouldn't have blocked because I have the lifelinking thing, but now even one removal spell doesn't get me stuck at 20 here. Yeah, but yeah, so basically equipment's kind of sucked, so people started thinking equipment sucked. Makes sense. And the net result is that Cookie can fly under the radar a little. I guess they can use this to nug me down to 19, make me discard. And then, and then I'll be able to, I won't be able to gain the draw a card off this, but I think it's still going to be good. Okay, so they just played the Kennel Master, sure. Ooh. Okay, yeah, I mean, play this, play the cleric, put a counter on this. I know I can't equip the thing right away, but now I get to hit and then make a counter, and I think I equip the cleric now. Paying 2 and then draw a card end of turn. Yeah, this is going quite nicely, quite nicely. No, because they nugged me for 3, right? So I wouldn't actually, I would then a 19 and then I could attack. Oh, no, you're right. I would go to 21. That is true. It actually wouldn't have worked. So now they get to get back Fearless Liberator, I suppose. That's okay. Hokia's Raptor in this archetype, it's quite good. You do want the Battlefield Raptor because you want cheap cards and you want flyers. It does both those things a lot. It's better than Codespell Cleric. It just turns out I saw four Codespell Clerics and one Battlefield Raptor. This guy's definitely doing the, like, yeah, voice. I actually think, nah, you know what? Yeah, I should block. Because if I block this, I stay at 21, so I draw off the Elixir, and it gets this off the board, which I think this is a fine trade. Even though I have a bunch of equipment out, this will give me plenty of bodies to equip here. What is the card I underestimated the most? Probably the Wings. The Wings have been, like, legit great. Yeah. This town's too big to not big enough, or it's big enough for two of us, or whatever that song, that weird Australian song is. I'm not worried about putting them on a two-turn clock. If they don't kill the Raptor, then they're just in a lot of trouble here. And they're foretelling here. Because I'm drawing extra cards every turn here. I don't need to move the Wings, I don't think. Yeah, let's just hit. Boom. Boom. And do I want to equip? I don't think it even helps to equip on them right now, so there's no point in doing that. I thought green-white is not very good, which makes a green-white gold card less good, but Metal Rain, you can splash Maja pretty easily in, like, a white X deck. Skull Raid, sure. I'm glad I drew a card, so they only drew one card there. Cyril's Packmate is the Kavu Climber for a new generation. Kavu Climber used to be a good card. It's like a Cyril's Packmate that costs more and does less. I guess I'll block there. I got 7 wins with a 3 Path to the World Tree deck, and I'm on track to get 7 here. I'm going to be at 6-2 after I win this game, which I'm fairly sure I'm going to. Demon Bolt? Demonic Bolt? I guess I have a lot of mana. Let's just move the pick over there. And then that way, if they had a way to kill my thing, I would rather them kill the Shield Mate, and then let's move Gold Vein pick to this one. And I'll just keep the land in hand. Was the Field of the Dead deck a meme? I don't know about that. Field of the Dead. Field of the Dead in Cube has been good. Sweet. All right, we're 6-2. All righty, let's see if we can get 7 wins. This is a fine hand, but not, I mean, they're mulliganing. I don't know. I'll keep this hand. 4 lands, kind of a lot, though. It's a quarter of the more than a quarter of the lands in our decks. Ooh, the Battlefield Raptor Mirror. Oh, another land. Uh-oh. If I don't draw any more land, I could be fine. But if I draw too many more lands, this is going to be a little rough here. Oh, turn 2 Colossal Plow. I might have to bound in gold that. We'll see. If they play something like an ox here. All right, the Colossal Plow is coming in. Turn 2 Plow, turn 3 ox, the combo. All right. Let's see if they have a follow-up into a Goldmaw Champion? Wow, they're trotting pretty hard here. I guess I'll bound in gold the Colossal Plow, pass, and then take some damage here. But this is tough. This is just the nut draw here. Are they going to use Goldmaw? That's a good sign. I wasn't blocking anyway, and that means they have nothing else to do here. Okay, another land. No, why me? All right. Why not bound the ox? Because then I end up in a spot where once they get more creatures, this hits me. I don't care about giant ox. I'm not going to beat giant ox. Or, sorry, I might not beat giant ox. I'm not going to lose to an 0-6 wall that's really weak against this deck. I think it would be fairly foolish to bound in gold the ox instead of the plow. I've drawn half the lands on my deck now, and that's just about, and that's not where I want to be. Oh no. Mm-hmm. Well, don't I look foolish? Losing to the ox again. I'm definitely not beating Giant Ox, as it turns out. I'm at 9. So we'll see who they tap with their Gold Maw Champion. Because I'm in a spot where I might be able to double block Gold Maw Champion or double block the Colossal Plow. We'll see what they're gonna. They should not tap down my Gold Maw Champion. That's the important thing. I don't think. Yeah. All right. Well, I guess I'll double block here and go to 2. But they lose their Gold Maw Champion if they have any cards in hand. Obviously, I just lose so badly. Yeah. I mean. All right. And so ends our glorious adventure into Mono White. Our planes are getting plowed really badly by that Colossal Plow. Boom, and that'll do it. That'll finish us at 6-2. But, you know, we started 0-2, so getting to 6-2 does the thing. And pretty happy with how this deck turned out, this Mono White deck. This video, of course, was sponsored by Ultimate Guard. The sponsors Team Channel Fireball. Go to ultimateguard.com. Check out deck boxes, sleeves, all the other cool things. This deck was sweet, though. I do think that we built the deck a lot better after the first couple games. We were playing Elixir in the second pick and not playing like Warhorn Blast. And I think I got trapped a little too much by the two Kaya's Onslaughts because they are so good. But, well, learning for next time. And I think this deck ended up pretty nice indeed.